A short while ago, we made a Numberphile video about a problem to do with Diophantine equations and whether numbers can be written as a sum of three cubes.
We still don't know an answer to that one.
So we've not yet been able to find any integers which when you sum their cubes, you get 33. And since then, we've had some breaking news. So there's a paper that's appeared, and someone has actually gone away and this guy, Sander Huisman, has gone away and calculated a new solution to one integer that was previously unknown, whether it was a sum of three cubes or not. Well, indeed, he credits the Numberphile video. He sort of found that it was kind of interesting enough to just have a go at pushing the boundaries of knowledge a little bit further, and he managed to sort of get this going on a computer search, and I think he was searching for something like 12.5 CPU years on a bank of computers in Lyon, and was able to find a new solution for the number 74. So we are interested in, suppose that we're given an integer k, can you find integers x, y, and z, and these can be both positive and negative, such that x cubed plus y cubed plus z cubed is equal to k. If we just look at all of the integers between 1 and 99, as of last time, there were only three integers on that list for which we didn't have an answer about whether they could be written as a sum of three cubes or not. And those were 33, 42, and 74. Now we know that this last number here, 74, is actually represented as a sum of three cubes. Do you want me to write it down for you?
Of course.
So here we go. So 74 is now known to be equal to minus 28465029255588 all cubed plus 66229832190556 cubed plus 28345010569777 cubed. And there's the new solution. He also found some new solutions for larger values of k. But kind of the interesting thing is for k less than 100, we now only have two more numbers to worry about here. The number 33 and the number 42.
And are they solvable? Are they out there? Like, should other people be firing up their computers?
Or? Well, absolutely. So far, thanks to Sander, we now know that if we're interested in the number 33, there are certainly no solutions in which the size of x, y, and z are bounded by 10 to the 15. So that's a pretty big range. So you're going to have to look further than that. Who knows? It may well be that if you just look up to 10 to the 16, you'll find a solution.
And 42, do we know any more about that? Or?
Nope, nothing about that. It's not earth-shattering news. I mean, we thought for a long time that these things do have solutions. In fact, we think that there are infinitely many solutions for each of these values of k. Our expectation is that they are very, very sparse. So you might come across one, and then the next time you come across another one might be many, many years down the line before you've got computers big enough to find them. So, I mean, it's gratifying that this is kind of coinciding with our belief that these things do indeed have solutions, but in terms of sort of fundamental mathematics that's gone into this, I would say that's not the case. It's kind of just a more extensive computer search.
Not every Numberphile viewer is going to make a contribution like Sander, but the people you see listed on the screen have helped us out. They're among our Patreon supporters, and we really appreciate it. If you'd like to join their ranks with no matter how small a contribution, you can go to patreon.com/numberphile. I'll put a link in the video description. And by the way, you can see on the screen at the moment a link to our original video, which inspired Sander's investigation. But we've also got a new video, and that's all about those values of k for which it's impossible to find a solution. Not even Sander's going to find one for that. And if you'd like to see the proof, we've just put it on Numberphile 2. And by the way, while you're over on Numberphile 2, why not subscribe to the channel? Because I don't always mention it here, and you might occasionally stumble over something you didn't even know existed.